activity going on with this cherry tree. There are lots of black aphids. And tons of ants. They're just running around. It's a very warm day, so they're scurrying around, you know, doing whatever they do. I don't know what they do, but in addition to ants scurrying around, I see a lot of these little black solitary wasps flying around, a lot of them. And I'm thinking that they're probably depositing their little eggs onto the aphids. So I'm kind of troubled because I don't want to break the cycle of the wasp being able to reproduce itself. Because there's a lot of them. I mean, there's plenty. So, I'm thinking, and you know, the aphid situation is not so crazy this year. You know, in the last couple years, the aphids were really... I'm covered in ants now from looking at these things. The aphids were really thick on the tree, and every time I would spray... with anything, I was sprayed, sprayed pyrethrum, and I put neem oil on it, and I finally concocted, a homemade recipe with, cayenne pepper, and, nettle leaf, and garlic, and then I put either dish detergent, you know, dish soap, or soap wort. I boiled the soap wort in there. If I didn't have soap wort, I would just use dish detergent. So anyway, that seemed to work like a charm. However, I don't want to use that this year if these nice wasps are all over the place helping me out. Excuse me. Like I said, the black fly or the black aphids aren't so bad this year. You know, one thing that I did was that it's been raining for like a week. It's been good rain. Not like constant, but you know, every day we get a good amount of rain. But I had a pail underneath. I had that pail down there over the pot, and so the water wasn't actually going into the container, and for that reason it's now kind of bone dry. I just gave it a lot of water, but some of the cherries I noticed are kind of shriveling. I don't know if you can see that. So shooting myself in the foot. In any case, I'm hoping that the plant will recover and that the cherries will come back. They'll plump up nicely, and it'll also help the tree to fight the good fight, along with the wasps. Meanwhile, I suppose I ought to like find the source of these ants, because they're the ones that I think I kind of see one place where they're coming from. So anyway, I'm going to try and work on that. But I'm not going to spray for the aphids. Not yet. I don't know. Maybe in a couple of days if I see stuff getting worse, then I might do something. But right now it seems... You know, it seems like a lot of activity, but it almost seems like an equal proportion of ants and wasps. I see a lot of wasps. You see the ants? Anyway, that's it. My sage is in bloom. Kind of wonderful. And look at this. It's my Schizandra. No, not Schizandra. Schizanthus. Schizandra is a Chinese herb. Isn't it gorgeous? There's that color. There's this color. This is a very similar one. There's this pale pink. That's gorgeous. There's this. Aren't they cute? They call these poor man's orchids. You can kind of see why. They have, I guess, this, it's kind of like six petals. And, you know, the one petal kind of hangs down on the bottom. They're so cute. And, you know, of course, there's my Dianthus here. These are so fragrant. Excuse me. And this one here, I look out the window, and it's like instant cheer. So gorgeous. That color is amazing. My kitty cat is stranded. She's not stranded, but she's kind of lazy. She doesn't want to go around the back. She's like, open the door. All right, come on. Come on. All right, so I'm bound to do a few things in another garden, so I don't even know where I'm going to end up. However, I guess I'll let you know how it goes. Thanks for watching.